Then comes the spices. You know, then we talk about spices. So if you are eating meat, so always cover it with fennel, because the fennel has the property to absorb all the toxins. Because whenever you eat fennel, it destroys phlegm in your body. Every dead thing what you eat has got phlegm. It has got stagnation. So when you put it with fennel, that stagnation goes. That meat becomes tender. It becomes very easy for you to digest. The same thing what we use with fenugreek. Use fenugreek. Fenugreek is a seed when you eat with each day in the morning. What we say, you know, it helps your muscles to live. It helps your muscles to contract very well. So make it a part of your diet. Cumin. Cumin is a very good herb. You know, always whenever you are creating any vegetables, any pulses, always use cumin. As those pulses will cause you acidity. It won't be digested. It's not easy to digest vegetables also. A lot of people feel vegetables are light. No. Vegetables are also very difficult to digest. They have got very strong enzymes in them. Starches in them, which are very difficult by the body to break down. If they don't break down, we get the fiber, they throw it out. But we are not eating it for fiber, we are eating it for nutrition. That chlorophyll content has to be digested. Use cumin. If you don't cook your vegetables without cumin, then you are missing out on a lot of things. If you don't want cumin, just boil water with cumin, soak the vegetables and cook it in it. But that is something which you can use. So these are small changes if you do. It's fine. Somebody asked me the question that what if we don't drink water, what do we drink? So in the morning when you have breakfast, have a juice. But juice should be at least carrot or pomegranate. Do not have juices of fruits. A lot of people, as you drink like this big glass of orange juice. It is not logical to drink, because this much of orange juice will require 20 oranges to. Can you eat 20 oranges? You cannot eat 20 oranges, then how can you drink the juice? People know, I am drinking juice, it is good for the body. No, you are going to increase acidity, you are going to increase inflammation, you are going to make your blood acidic. Don't drink. If you drink that much cranberry juice, you are going to get kidney failures. If you are into verge into your body, somebody has got kidney transplants because they, then you are going to go for it. Organ rejections occur, organ starts failing if you drink a lot of cranberry juice. Drink less. Earlier we used to say people don't used to be ill. Now if you are on any immunosuppressant drugs like methotrexate or sacrolimus or tacrolimus, you know, which are given in organ transplant, the first thing they tell you, don't drink cranberry juice. So understand. So you have to understand, we think, oh, it's cranberry, it is antioxidant, it is this, it is going to cause you problems. So only drink in limit what you want. So you have to eat this. Only one juice which is said in Ayurveda we can drink is pomegranate juice. So take it out fresh. Crush it, go the old way. Don't go put it into a blender. Don't use that. Because the juice has to be drunk only this much. 150 ml, more than enough. You don't have to drink like gallons and gallons of juice. So that's with the breakfast, if you have to drink this much juice. In India, we say with lunch, if you have to drink buttermilk. If you have got good yogurt, put, if you get like this much yogurt with you, put 3 parts of water in it. Take this wooden pestle, you will get this wooden pestle. Just do it with your hands, don't use that blender and grinder. Just make it homogeneous, let make it flat. Add little bit of salt. Drink this much, maybe little bit more, with your lunch. And with dinner, drink milk, warm milk, not cold milk. These things will help you digest if you require to drink anything with the food. If not, it is not a compulsion. But don't drink water. So these are the basis. If anyone follows, then most of the disorders can be solved. These are the things, if you start incorporating from tomorrow in your house, then your children benefit. It is the same thing. You are not compromising, you are not educating your husband or child to not eat fries or chips. You are just changing the kosher. You are just changing the salt. 4 days, 5 days, they will crave, but because it is getting at home, they will eat. But that major difference will make. The French fries do not cause you the problem. The salt causes you the problem, because you are putting it from above. It loads the kidneys. Potato never causes you the problem. But we think of French fries bad, fried food nothing. It's not like fried food is bad and non-fried oily food is good. No. Always use refined, unrefined oil. Don't never use refined oil. If you take out, if you refine oil, nothing is there in it. It might just appeal to your brain. Oh, there is no fats in it, but don't do that. You will be causing muscle loss. You know, your muscle will start wasting. you will start getting constipation. So use unrefined oil. Take those cotton, you got so much cotton here. Take those seeds, press the oil, cotton seed oil, very good for the body. Cook in cotton seed oil. You have got abundance in US. You'll get it. You get the seeds anyways like this. Take the oil. It's very good. Not something you have to import something from India or anywhere else. These are small, cheap things which you can do without any cost.
Did you say cotton seed?
Cotton seed, yeah.
Milk?
You have cotton seeds. Find it out.
We have cotton seeds?
He said press the cotton seeds. Huh? You gotta make your own.
Oh, where do you get cotton seeds?
You get cotton seeds. Go to a farm. There are a lot of people who...
A lot of people in the South.
South make cotton. It's the biggest exporter, one of the biggest exporters. You have sunflower. You have got a lot of sunflower farming. You've got a lot of sunflowers. Use sunflower seeds. Make sunflower oil.
Yes.
So see, these are all available. It's not that you have to buy it from somewhere. But get your seeds. Get your oil pressed. It is not a big deal. It just takes a few, you know, few hours if someone has that facility.
What about using ghee?
Ghee is also good. Ghee is also good. But again, it depends if you are preparing or that cow, that milk should be proper. Ghee is the best. Cow's ghee if you use, but because I'm talking, a lot of people are not aware, I'm not aware if people are aware of ghee, so I'm talking about oil. But if you use ghee, it is still the best. But you have to use it, but you have to be very careful sometimes with ghee. Is that if you are really very weak, you know, you are really very weak, then you should use ghee with caution because it is very difficult to digest. So whenever you use ghee, you have to always use ghee after it has prepared, like when you prepare the bread, you use ghee afterwards. Don't put ghee while preparing it. Never put oil while preparing something. Always put it afterwards. So body doesn't transcend, it just uses it as a catalyst. When it goes inside the dough, the body has to digest it. So that also is a very difference. But always use ghee. If you got good quality cow's ghee, a lot of time you get ghee from buffalo, we don't know from what you are getting. So check your sources. If you get really good ghee, India, from India, you get A2 ghee, it doesn't matter. Why I'm telling India? Because India is the best A2 milk in, after Africa, India is the best. India and Africa both are the same. So you can get it. Get this ghee, it is fine. When you get the ghee, don't use it straight away. Put that ghee in your storage for 5 months, 6 months, then start using it. The more old, the better. Same with jaggery. Put it in the storage. Same with honey. Put it in the storage. Don't use it fresh. Fresh honey is like a poison. You have to use honey as it is aged. But it depends, you know, when you get the fresh honey, not the boiled honey. A lot of time you boil the honey and cool it down. That is of no use. That is useless.
But raw.
Raw honey. Raw pressed honey you get, just put it inside. Okay. If you are using it regularly, put it inside. 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months. In my house, I use like 5 years old honey, 6 years old ghee. That much old we use. Very light. Very good for the eyes. So this is also very important, how much you age your system. And this was like nothing, not a rocket science. Everybody in their ethnicities used to age certain things and use afterwards. Some things were used fresh. Whenever you use fennel, use it fresh. So in your kitchen cabinets, I always say, get an architect, you know, some people create this shelf and put this soil in it and start growing herbs. You know, just put a watering system, it waters down and all these herbs starts growing. So use that system. So fennel, always use fresh. Don't buy it from the market. The fresher fennel you use, the better the thing.
When you said put fennel on meat, do you mean the fresh fennel? Not the
fresh
seeds?
Fennel you can use, just rub it with meat, put it inside. It's always better.
So not the seeds, but the actual stuff.
No, the seeds only.
Oh, the seeds.
You have to seed it out. Yeah, but it should be fresh. It should not be like 1 year old, 6 months old. The more old it gets, the more it loses its properties. So certain things are always good quality. So use it. You don't require much peppermint. These are certain things you can just grow somewhere in your. You don't require much space also. But you will get this fresh. When you use it fresh, you will get the flavor. It will do their job as spices. Never use powder. When you take cinnamon or cardamom, use fresh. Get the fresh quills. You know, there is also a way. You know, I have written a spice book in which I have given how to check for adulteration, how to check for quality. So in that, this quills and all, how to check it, if they are dead quills, if they are used quills, how exactly to know? What kind of a cloves you are using? You know, if they should be full with oil, there should be black cloves. You should not use spent cloves. Sometimes the cloves are so spent, they are so brown, the oil is taken out. We don't understand. We just see the aroma and we take it. No use. If the fresh cloves are used, if you are suffering from asthma, it will go away just by using cloves in your system. You will see that if you are using this pump and you use cloves in your food, you will see within 4, 5 days, 6 days you are not using that pump. Just cloves, nothing else. They are so effective. But you have to check the quality. So checking that quality also is an art. So that information, what the group of spices you are going to use, 10 spices, 5 spices, 6 spices, it's not necessary Indian spices, oregano, parsley, whatever spice you use. Check what is the quality, what is the adulterant, how many species are there, what I am using, am I getting the best, is this what I am meant to use. If you make those researches, then you will get good flavor in your food. Your people also will not be bent on eating outside. If you are getting like good food in the house, why would people go out to eat? The same food can be made more tasty by these vessels, by the correct usage of these spices, it will be fine. Because that is what, as I said, the history created, right? When people started understanding spices, America was discovered. Otherwise, it wouldn't have been discovered. Because earlier in the Scandinavian year, people were just like boiling meat and putting some rosemary, thyme and eating it. So when pepper was discovered, it was sold in gold. You know, people used to give gold and take pepper. It was a currency of the old Rome. That much the spices were valued. Why? Because they brought taste, they brought culinary affection to food. They made the food more palatable, they made the food more enjoyable. They found light. The same food which was so difficult to digest, this meat, became so tender, so easy to digest, people started falling in love with it. People started using spices to create wines. Earlier wines were just created in a simple way, then they started putting cinnamon. Now you see all this expensive wine, cinnamon flavor, peach flavor, this flavor. Why? Spices. It made it even more beneficial to drink them. They understood it, but making the spices into wine and drinking it with meat, you know, we are not gaining weight. We are becoming strong. You see the French cuisine, you know, they eat so much of cheese and all these things. They are drinking wine. So they have specific wines. If you go to an old guy, when I went to France, I went to meet one of the old person who. So he told me all these things. They used to experiment in their own breweries. What is going to go? Which meat, what goes? Why? Because they wanted to eat that meat. But they didn't want it to have its effects. They didn't want it to feel like after eating meat, oh, I want to sleep. They wanted to feel fresh because they had to go to the fields. So they used to drink wine. Some people macerated these wines and created drinks like palinka or something in Czech Republic. There is another spirit. So they used to drink it before. When I went to Hungary, I came to know about this. I brought it home. So whenever you drink it before and eat meat with it, you don't find anything, any ill effects of it. The same meat you eat without drinking it, you will feel full. You will feel as if, you know, you have eaten, you know, you don't need to walk. You just need to sleep. Any meal which gives you that is not a good meal. Second thing, never combine foods, like never combine dairy with meat. You know, a lot of people have a habit that, you know, they eat some burger, they eat something and go and have an ice cream or a shake. That will cause you even more problems. A lot of time you do it. You know, when you eat something, after that your entries go or whatever it is you go, then you have a sweet dish in the end when you go. Everyone wants it. Avoid having that. So what food you want to eat, you eat only that. You enjoy it, taste, savor it, taste. You want to eat sweet, I told you eat jaggery. Go have some jaggery with you, eat it, it will help you digest. Sometimes it is okay when you go out to enjoy, it is not that it's a no-no rule. But if you are doing it regularly, then it causes a problem. I said the burger doesn't cause the problem, the shake doesn't cause the problem. Burger and shake causes the problem. So it is like that. So these are small things which you can incorporate in your life. You know, you can do it practically, give it a go for like 1 month, 1.5 months in whatever time space you are and see the changes. Ask your children who are taking this food, what changes they are feeling in their social life. You'll see a considerable change in their behaviors. The hyper people will start calming down. You know, they'll become more concentrated, more grounded, because it all affects. It all affects the system. Inflammation goes down, juices are secreted properly, their constipation starts resolving, they start getting a sound sleep, muscles relax. These simple changes. You don't require like big herbs, big procedures to do it. So in my life, I've never used like panchakarma in my entire treatments. Anytime I've never required. I treat patients from cancers to everything, never required. We treat on these simple spices, just these simple things. Very rarely we have to use some big medicines. These changes I always tell everyone, because my emphasis is always to make them independent. They should not come back to me. Once they are gone, I don't want to see them. So make these changes. It is not like, okay, I have cured my cough, now I have come here for my acidic problem. Everything should be what you have told me, what you have not told me. That is Ayurveda. So once I catch this, you make these changes, the only point then lies is your commitment to do it. As I said, some people won't give up the caffeine but pay $3,000 more to take a medicine which will allow caffeine. That, then you are at fault. Then no one can help you. So that kind of a thing, if you search for, then you will get that kind of a treatment. If you are inwardly conscious, then you know, you will understand why you are suffering from certain disorders. Many of those phantom pains, phantom problems will disappear. Only the real problems might remain, which you can then, you know, consult some knowledgeable person and get over with it.